Brands Hatch is one of our favourite tracks actually in the game. It's kind of our go-to location when we want to actually test, you know, physics and things like that in the game. Project Cars is coming out in November, so here we are. We wanted to make sure that people get out onto the track and experience what it's like in real life.
So my name is Oliver James Webb. I am the road and test driver for BAC Mono and also a professional racing driver in the European Le Mans Championship. A day like today at Brands Hatch is great for us all to be involved with. It's great for the press to see and for us involved with the game to also compare literally on a track that's considered as the game's home track.
The single seaters were amazing, really raw, like a great kind of raw experience. I had a moment sat in there where the wing mirrors were kind of like vibrating away, and I was very conscious of like the helmet around here as well. And I remember seeing that movie Rush, and for a moment, like every kid dreams, like, oh, I dream, like I feel like a race driver.
And that's where I can play a bit of a part as well, really showing how realistic a lap time we can get out of the car on track and the bounce and how it feels and how the track looks, and then coming upstairs into hospitality and playing it and people seeing for themselves.
The BMWs are fantastic, you know, you put your foot down and they go like anything. My instructor was telling me to brake all the time, you know, which is something that happens in real life, I guess, as well.
Normally you kind of play the game and build up to going out in the car, and we've turned that round and people go out in the car and they play it in the game, and it's wow, this really is how I just felt.
It was a fantastic experience. We've been making games for quite a long time, over 10 years now, and we've worked on two of the biggest racing franchises ever, you know, Test Drive and Need for Speed. But we wanted to do our own thing, we wanted to make our own IP, our own franchise, and when we were doing that, we knew that we wanted to do it our own way.
So I first started getting involved with Project Cars when I was doing some work with BAC and they needed a bit more help on the car to make it work in game. I was just kind of having to fiddle around at the end of the day, and we just decided to have a look at some of the cars and tracks.
It is a massive risk, you know, like making a game and then hoping 2 years later, 3 years later, that the game actually is something that players actually want to be involved in.
Every time I came back from a race weekend, I could give advice on where the sun comes up or where these new trees have been planted or the new posts that go up, or there's new tweaks to the engine that maybe the manufacturer won't normally tell games about. So it really just gave that in-depth extra bit of information that I've never seen in any other game.
Today we announced the driver network. It breaks down into a number of different things. First, you've got your profile. So it tells you what kind of player you are, what your favorite things in the game, like your stats, what things do you love playing, what are the things you don't play and therefore maybe you should try. You also can compete in driver network time trial. The chances of you being online at the same time as your friend are quite slim. So asynchronously, you can see his time, you can try to beat it, and if he's so far ahead of you, you can download his ghost and see how he actually did that particular lap. There's also community events for people to like take part in. These are things that are regularly scheduled, and sometimes they even have real-world prizes to actually compete for. There's also your driver network highlights. These are your prettiest pictures, your most proud moments in the game. We'll be curating the best bits on our YouTube and Flickr galleries as well. The community is extremely important to us. We wouldn't have been able to make the Project Cars without those guys, and we are supporting the community after release with the driver network. Everything you would have seen on the web, from screenshots to trailers, has been made by the community. They talk to us, they can private message me, other members of the staff, and they can see progress of how the game is being made every single day of the week. And that means that there's a certain level of confidence there that what we're making is something that the community really want to play.
You can really have that pure simulation feel with the weather playing a part and the treacherous conditions on the track and the cars being as realistic as possible, and then fine-tune your AI and the other people to react how you want, their aggressiveness and how they react. So you can really have the own custom game sitting in your living room at home.
I mean, we are very kind of firmly putting our flag in the ground and saying, if you are craving an authentic, realistic experience with real-life licensed cars, real-life tracks from around the world, Project Cars is like your only choice this particular year.